Now, they were one of the most iconic rock bands, soaring up the charts around the world, and the Divinyls had us rocking throughout the 80s and 90s with hits like these. Such an iconic band. The music has lasted, endured through the decades. Sadly, we lost lead singer Chrissy Amphlett. She passed away in 2013. And now guitarist Mark McEntee is getting the band back together for a really special tour. And he's with us on the panel now. Put your hands together for Mark.
Thanks so much. I feel like a big thorn here. And... middle of all these lovely roses.
Oh, you can stay forever.
Well, you don't mind if I move in, do you?
Oh, not at all.
We'll go on tour with you.
Yeah.
Well, you're all welcome.
Now, tell us how hard it was to begin with losing Chrissy back in 2013. I mean, is it something that you ever truly get over? Because she seems to have left such a hole in the fabric of Australian music.
In the fabric of the music, yeah. Well, that's just the point. I mean, I think it's been long enough to be, you know, something like that hits you really very much, you know, because you're so close, you wrote all these songs together, you work together, you sweat together, you're on the road together, really camaraderie, you know. But the thing is that I feel it's time to celebrate the songs that we wrote together, and I want to get out and play my music again. It's that simple. And it's been 12 years since last being on the road.
Wow.
And it's taken me that long to... I've had lots of offers to go out and do a tour. This singer, that singer, whatever, singer, singer, singer. It took me 12 years to actually find someone in the studio, which was just a fluke.
Wow.
A Baltimore girl.
Baltimore.
From Baltimore.
Who is she?
Lauren Ruth Ward is her name, am
You've
I right?
You've got a name. That's right.
And how is it a fluke?
Well, because my mate Billy rang me. I was staying in Los Angeles in... at a hotel called the Chateau Marmont.
Oh, that's very appropriate.
Have you heard of it?
Mark, yes,
so
I'm very familiar with it.
Well, we call it the Shat.
With a C.
Depends how big a knife you have, really.
Yeah, with a C.
With a C, like cat in French.
CH, you know, Frenchy, Wenchy, Woo.
Yeah.
And I got a phone call, said, my mate Billy Steinberg, who Chrissy and me used to work with when we were in LA. Yeah.
Is this her?
This is her.
That's her.
Wow, what a glory.
I know. Now, she has got a killer voice.
Well, that's what I was going to ask you, because of all the things with the Divinyls, Chrissy's voice was so unique.
I know, I know.
So, and fans are just going to be thrilled. So was that the deciding factor, her voice, Mark?
Absolutely. Dear Lauren was recording one of our songs in the studio, and my friend Billy said, why don't you come in and play a bit of guitar? I said, all right, I'll come in and play. Then when I heard her sing, I thought, oh, she's a great voice. Soulful, Janis Joplin-y. And I thought, well, if anybody could do Dear Chrissy and my songs justice, it would be Lauren.
Mark, we've seen a couple of other big bands do this. We've seen Queen replace Freddie Mercury now touring with Adam Lambert. In Excess, of course, did it with a couple of incarnations, including John Stevens and then J.D. Fortune. sometimes there's a bit of a backlash from some fans. But it does happen.
Yeah. There it is.
Oh, don't be afraid. She'll be amazing.
But both of those bands managed to sell out big tours and in Queen's case certainly continue to do so.
Well, it's a matter of playing your music because it runs through your DNA. I write the songs with Chrissy. I mean, if we're in Egypt, you'd probably build the pyramid, put the pharaoh in, get rid of everyone. But we're not there, we're here. I just want to play the songs and give them to people, and it's time to celebrate what Chrissy has written, her lyrics, everything like that, sung in a beautiful way.
Chrissy and you were, of course, in a relationship as well as all those other things you mentioned earlier. How do you think she'd feel about this?
I think she'd be really happy, actually. I think she'd be looking down there. Sure, you know, when it comes my time to go, she might have a bit of a rolling pin up there. You know, there you go, here you're. I think she'd be really happy because we're singing the songs. We're going to play the songs, you know. It's about, really, the songs. And I've been offered to do the tour with a lot of people, but I just thought this girl, Lauren, was the first girl that I thought could really handle her.
Right.
And, Mark, we've seen lots of biopics being made recently.
Biopics?
You know, like a Bohemian Rhapsody, like the movie Elton John movie. What about a Divinyls movie?
Yeah. A diopic.
You're a hoot. It's got to be a comedy.
Diviopic. Diviopic.
Have you been approached?
I've been approached many times.
Really? About a movie?
No, not about a movie. Not about a movie. But I have been approached.
Who would play you? Who would play you in a biopic if one was to be made?
I don't think anyone would want to give that a go.
Maybe a Ben Mendelsohn or someone like that?
Ben Mendelsohn with an H. Yes. With a H.
Yeah, with a H. Like Hudson. With a H. Like
Hudson.
He would be good.
You get it, Angela.
You'd have to make a cameo, wouldn't you?
You think?
She could play herself.
I can play myself. You guys.
I could star as the crocodile. Maybe.
Hey, can we ask you about Serena Williams and her cover recently of I Touched Myself? We just want to show everyone at home if they've forgotten.
I don't want anybody else. When I think about you, I touch myself.
I mean it was never written as that in that aspect, but that was something that, you know, I mean, that's the use of the song.
It's pointing towards breast cancer, it had a really beautiful synergy.
And Serena sing, though?
Of course, was a driving force behind that.
Exactly. I think it's fantastic. Mm. I really do. I think it's fantastic. You know, it's a different interpretation of that song. But it's great that they wanted to, you know, whatever good it can do is a great thing. I mean, God, we all want the people we love around, don't we?
Yeah,
yes,
absolutely.
Forever.
For as long as we can.
Yeah.
And touching your breasts and checking there are no lumps is a great way to make sure you stay around a bit longer. It is a terrific message for the song.
Exactly.
Having seen a beautiful rendition of the song that Serena did there, have you ever seen anyone sing any of your songs and had to politely smile and go, yeah, that's great? You know, have you ever seen a cover band or...
I suppose, you know, if you go out and look on the net and stuff, you get a lot of these tribute bands and stuff, you know, and I think that's all well and good. Look, when you write a song or do a song, I think, you know, you put it out there and it's really for people to do what they want with. Yeah. It's not up to... you to necessarily go, oh, I don't want it done like that, or whatever. I mean, you give it to people, don't you? So...
You can't be precious, can you?
You can't be too damn precious.
Oh, I love you.
But all you can do is go out, if you feel like doing it and the time's right and you think the time's right, you've got to do what's in your DNA, haven't you?
So will we get
I was born to play guitar and that's all I wanted to do.
Will we get new songs or will we hear all of the Divinyls that we know?
Oh, well... No, basically, we're going to play all the songs that people know.
Good.
I mean, I want to do all the songs that people know. If people pay for a ticket or they want to come to a gig, you've got to give them songs they know and you've got to rock it. You know, I just want to rock it and sweat on people.
Well, the Divinyls kick off their tour in Western Australia in February and then they head around the country. Tickets are available at all the usual outlets. Mark McEntee, you are a dude and thank you so much.
It was so nice, honestly. It was lovely to come on here.
Put some of that vibe.